Welcome staff and students to Northeast King's Education Center's Remembrance Day ceremony. As we join together today for a Remembrance Day ceremony, we would also like to acknowledge that we are in Mi'kma'ki, the unceded, traditional, and ancestral territory of the Mi'kmaq.
We may not be able to gather together this year in the traditional fashion that we are accustomed to. However, through this online stream ceremony, our thoughts and hearts will still be joined together in remembrance for those who have served and continue to serve our country. We will remember them.
Our armed forces and military personnel put the country before self. Just 2 minutes before the signing of the armistice to end World War I, Private George Price, who grew up in this area, was killed in Villesurhin, Belgium. He was the last Canadian to die in World War I and fought to the end to defend freedom, our freedom. He did not hear the bells that rang out across Europe on November 11, 1918 to celebrate war's end. Today we honor those who understood freedom was worth defending and would fight to the end to do so.
At this time, we ask that everyone please stand for the playing of our national anthem. Thank you. You may now be seated.
Good afternoon. My name is Sophie Stockvis, and it is a privilege to have this opportunity to lead you all through this moment of remembrance.
War has touched the lives of Canadians of all ages, all races, all social classes, fathers, sons, daughters, sweethearts. Many lives were selflessly given for those of us born during this time. War can seem far removed from our daily lives. Let us never lose sight of the importance of a day like today. I am Ella Camo, and I am honored to share this moment of remembrance with you.
We often take for granted our Canadian values, our freedom to participate in cultural and political events, our right to live under a government of our choice. By remembering their service and their sacrifice, we recognize the tradition of freedom these men and women fought to preserve. On Remembrance Day, we acknowledge the courage and sacrifice of those who served their country and acknowledge our responsibility to work for the peace they fought hard to achieve. My name is Leah Bent, and it is our pleasure to be your MCs this afternoon.
At this time, we will have a special performance of a piece called Hymn to the Fallen. This will be performed by the Northeast King's Education Center Concert Band.
Thank you.
Thank you, NECA Concert Band, for that beautiful performance.
In the aftermath of the First World War, the poppy emerged as an international symbol of remembrance. We wear a poppy over our hearts to remember lost lives, therefore representing the many red poppies that filled the battlefields of Northern Europe, where so many gave their lives between 1914 and 1918. Many of those lives included a dear friend of the Canadian Lieutenant Colonel John McCrae. Following his loss, he was inspired to write the poem In Flanders Fields.
At this time, you will have the opportunity to view a special visual art presentation that has been created by the art students of Mr. Cran. This presentation also features a reading of In Flanders Fields by Ben Stevens and an audio recording of the song called Come From Home to Nova Scotia, which was composed by Ray Lewis in honor of Remembrance Day and sung by the Annapolis Valley Junior Honor Choir in a performance of Airman's Prayer by the NKEC Senior Concert Band.
In Flanders fields, the poppies blow between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place. And in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Thank you for sharing your creativity with us. Traditionally, during our ceremony, we reveal the Literacy and Posters Contest Award winners, which is usually presented by our local Legion members. However, this year, these awards will be announced at a later date during our morning announcements. So stay tuned. Thank you to all the students who participated in this opportunity.
At this time, we will have a performance of a piece called Abide by Me, performed by the Northeast Kings Education Center Senior Concert Band. As this piece is performed, we will be laying a wreath in honor of these lives lost in World War I, World War II, the Korean conflict, and Afghanistan. But beyond this, we honor all of those who have perished serving our country. We may not know them all, but we owe them all.
Thank you.
Thank you, NKEC Senior Concert Band.
Today is the day that's set aside to remember with gratitude and pride all those who served and died for our country and our freedom. We are now entering into a moment of reflection and remembrance. Please stand and remain standing. We will remember them. They shall not grow old as we, who are left to grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them. We will now have a moment of silence. Please continue to remain standing during the NKEC Senior Concerts Band performance of God Save the Queen.
Thank you.
As our service comes to a close, we would like to thank our fellow staff and students for taking this moment to reflect with us, lest we forget.